Okay, good afternoon and welcome to the first post-match briefing of this fourth window of the FIBA Basketball World Cup 2019. A very, very interesting game between Central African Republic and Mali. We have with us here coach of Central African Republic, Orich Marida, right?
Yeah, no,
Oh, coach didn't come. Okay. So what's your own name?
Beina.
Maurice Beina. Okay. And we have the captain of the team, Max Kuguri. Kuge. Ah, forgive me. Okay, coach, as it is, this is a very, 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 very close game. What would you say went wrong with your team?
I think we have the game at the first half. We have the game some of the part of the second half, but slowly they were getting us in the fourth rhythm, and when they went to the zone, they bothered us a lot, and they have us make mistake also on the way we attack the zone and. Small detail, but you were thinking you were up, you have enough points. I think it was 14 points at the time. And because we let them believe and get them to get some easy basket, actually put us in a difficulty, and we came up having this tough end of the game. So congratulations to Mali, because they still believe, even though we almost put them on the hole. But for us, we have to learn from that. I always say to the team, small detail make a difference between the big team. And I think we're on the way to get a big team, but we haven't have a chance to stabilize ourselves yet.
Okay. Would you say that it was overconfidence that cost you this match?
No, I don't think it's overconfident. When you have overconfident when you like way stronger than the other team, and it wasn't the case. We have those 14 points because we work hard and we play defense. And today we went into the game with the will to win. We never don't respect the adversary because I don't think we have the margin to do whatever you want. But no, for me, I think we just make mistake. We make small mistake, turnover, small mistake, turnover. Get us to have bad shot, get us to have more pressure, and get us to forgot what got us to the 14 points. We stop hitting the ball inside, and that make the difference. Comme je le disais, je pense qu'on était en avance sur le match. On avait notre stratégie, on avait notre game plan. On a bien exécuté au début. On a amené la balle où on voulait. On a pris les ballons qu'on voulait. Et je pense que c'est ce qui nous a permis de prendre de l'avance. Et on s'est mis dans la position de justement avoir la chance d'avoir le match. Mais malheureusement, on n'a pas su faire le nécessaire pour rester sur la stratégie qu'on a mis en place. Il faut qu'on donne du crédit au Mali, qui nous a présenté différentes formes de défense. Mais derrière, on n'a pas exécuté comme il fallait. Et les balles perdues nous ont coûté cher. La confiance a basculé d'un camp. Je pense qu'on avait la confiance de notre côté presque trois quarts du match. Et derrière, on n'a pas su finir. Donc, je disais tout à l'heure que c'est les petits détails qui font les grandes équipes. On est en progression pour approcher le top des grandes équipes africaines. Mais pour l'instant, on pêche encore sur les petits détails. Et je pense que ce match va nous servir de leçon. Un point, ça fait mal, mais un point, ça va nous obliger à complètement revoir nos plans. Et je pense que c'est là qu'on va voir si on est capable de progresser.
OK. If I get him correctly, it's exactly what he has said in French that he has said in English. Let's move over to the captain of the team. And captain, very, very tough game for you. I saw the way you reacted when the referee called, when the time was up. What do you think this means for Central African Republic?
Yeah. I apologize for my country because the job was done in the first half. It wasn't done. So if we play good in the second half, like we played in the first half, it wasn't done. So it's our fault. It's not coach's fault. It's player fault. Because we now followed the plan the coach gave us to play. That's why we failed.
Okay. Any questions from our guys?
Je pense que c'est ce qui nous a tués dans le match, parce qu'on pensait que Mali était prenable. Mais toutes les équipes sont venues ici pour chercher leur place. Donc au premier temps, on a joué notre basket et on est parti un peu avec l'excès de confiance dans le troisième quart-temps, essayer de jouer tranquille. Et on leur a laissé prendre la place tranquillement avec l'agressivité en défense. Ils nous ont présenté beaucoup de défense en man-man et en zone, tout ça. Ça nous a perturbé un peu. On a fait beaucoup de pertes de balles. Donc, c'est à nous maintenant. C'est à nous d'aller chercher les victoires contre les grandes équipes. Maintenant, on n'a plus de chance.
Not playing together as a team. And we tried to find an individual solution. Everybody was too much frustrated. And we weren't on the right way. But to be honest, the halftime was a key point for us. We talked together and we tell us the truth that we can't keep going that way, and we have to react as a team and play together and make efforts the one for the other. And that's really what we did in the second half. So I'm really proud of my players because we had a very good reaction, and that wasn't easy. Of course, we tried the help with changing a lot of defense and disorganized totally the opponent. I think they really had the difficulties against our defense because they didn't really expect what we were doing. But we finished with confidence, with a lot of effort and share between the players, and that really makes the difference on the final lane.
Okay, what was it you told your players at halftime? What did you tell them that made them wake up?
Yeah, there wasn't really wake up, you know. I mean, what's in the locker, stay in the locker. But we didn't have the right approach and the right spirit. I just told my players, we all here for Mali. Not for himself, not for me, not for anybody else than this country. We all represent, this country. Even if I'm French, I'm here to represent and help Mali to win games and the same with them. So we all have the same objective. So, and we all need to be only focused on one objective, represent with a lot of proud our country. And that wasn't about basketball, you know. That wasn't about technical skills and details. That was about spirit. And that's really what we changed. And I think it was obvious on the court that we came on second half with another face, and he helped us to win the game.
Okay. Any questions for the coach? Very short.
Non, c'est une équipe qu'on connaît. On savait qu'ils étaient redoutables, comme vous dites, c'est bien vrai. Je pense qu'on a fait l'entame qu'on voulait, on a bien démarré, mais on est retombé dans nos travers très vite. Dès qu'on a loupé un tir, perdu un ballon, très vite on a baissé la tête et on a lâché prise. Et cette équipe a pris de la confiance, a mis des tirs à trois points, mais ils ont trouvé beaucoup d'adresse à travers Max Cougar, mais les autres joueurs aussi. Et je crois que ça nous a mis un coup au moral. Et on a malheureusement un peu baissé la tête au lieu de réagir. Donc c'était important derrière d'avoir cette réaction. Mais encore une fois, je souligne le tempérament qu'ont eu les joueurs. Parce qu'on n'est pas les favoris de cette compétition. Mais nous, on veut vendre chèrement notre peau à chaque match. Et on veut prouver qu'on a notre place pour aller au bout. Et si on pouvait faire l'exploit d'amener le Mali à la Coupe du Monde, on serait les plus heureux.
Ok, coach, thank you very much. Jambo, big congratulations to you.
Thank you.
You have led like a warrior to bring your team back, and to win 1 point is very, very great. We want to say congratulations. But for you, what was the turning point that gave Mali victory?
We thank you for the wishes, and we didn't have a lot of different point to turn the game. The only point, like coach say, was the mindset, the spirit that we had in the second half. That was it. It wasn't about basketball. It wasn't about anything else. Was just about the spirit, the mindset we bring together in the second half. That's what changed the game. Nothing else.
Okay. Any questions?
Thank you, coach and captain. My name is Mike Mbonya. Right, for the Voice of America, English Africa Service. You have other matches to play: Senegal, Nigeria, and other teams in this tournament. What's the approach going to be like?
It's gonna be the same approach. We're not trying to think twice about anybody. We're not trying to double calculate anybody. It's a basketball game. Anything can happen. The same way we came today, the same way we played the second half, the same way we're gonna come for the next two games. Nothing gonna change. Ouais, pour le moment, on n'a pas le coach est là, on n'a pas encore parlé du Sénégal jusque là. On vient juste de finir le match de Centrafrique. Et après ici, on va rentrer, on va mettre des choses en place. Et c'est au coach qui nous a dit. Mais pour le moment, on a rien préparé pour le Sénégal jusque là. On aura des choses ce soir à travailler. On va en parler, on va regarder des films et on sera prêt pour demain. Il y a des choses à améliorer. Le Sénégal est grand. Le Sénégal est grand et costaud. On doit essayer vraiment de s'entraider plus d'abord fort au rebond et puis essayer d'arranger beaucoup de choses dans la rotation. On a toujours un petit pas de retard sur la rotation, et si on arrive à arranger ça et qu'on s'entraide au rebond, il y aura de bonnes choses. Ça sera un bon match.
Ok, thank you, Jambo. Congratulations once again. As you go for your next game, we say good luck.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.